I'm here at Donald's Boxing Club in Tarzana, California, where I caught up with boxing trainer Brandon Krause to talk to him about some questionable calls in boxing that should be called illegal shots, but they never are called. So many times, we know in boxing, we know the rules. You can't hit behind the head. You can't hit in the back. You can't hit below the belt. But what happens every time someone gets hit with one of those in your history of watching boxing?
So in 17 years of being involved in this sport, any questionable shots, and I wouldn't say low blows or kidney punches, but questionable shots to the head that maybe land high in the back of the head or behind the ear or even sometimes in the top of the head.
Those are illegal, right?
They are technically illegal, but anybody watching this video right now has seen a fight where a fighter was KO'd with a so-called illegal blow. And that referee, in the heat of the moment, when this guy's lying on the floor supine and another guy just got done clobbering him, he's going to start counting. He's not going to admonish the other fighter. Hopkins Pascal won. We were talking about Guerrero and Brewer. He hit him with a weird clubbing shot.
Guerrero got hit with a questionable shot. That
it was a questionable
been.
Shot, but hey, you stay down and the ref starts counting. How about
Alan Green
and Johnson? You know, yeah. He hit him behind the ear, but again, that referee starts counting. Fighters, your job is to get up and keep fighting, and don't count on the referee to have your back. Don't count on the referee
like
to
Zab
have...
Judah, Amir Khan. Zab Judah thought he got below the belt.
He thought he got low blow, and you know, the ref started counting about. But here's the other thing that us fighters and all fighters out there got to remember. Our sport is the one sport that we don't have that instant replay stuff that all the other sports
have.
They
should then.
You know?
They should instate it. Even football has it. You're limited in how many times you can appeal a call. But
it'll be difficult in boxing, though, because imagine a guy just got KO'd, is now concussed via a questionable shot. And let's say you review it and you take minutes and minutes and minutes to review it. And maybe your guy recovers, or maybe he doesn't recover. How do you recover from a concussion or something?
Dawson Hopkins, they looked at it afterwards and they reversed it, and they called it a no contest.
But this was months later down the line. Elliot, when the fight is happening, like Brandon said, it's in the heat of the moment. Things happen. They happen fast, and they happen too fast to the point where there's really not enough time to call a timeout and be like, oh, we got to look at the camera and let's see
no
the history.
Timeout.
Dawson Hopkins, that's an outlier because everybody knows that Hopkins used his political clout to sway that decision. Joe Schmo fighting Joe Schmo doesn't get that luxury to get fights overturned months and months later. Nobody does. So let's just throw that out the window. Anybody fighting for $200 a round out there, you know, the referee starts counting, he's just going to continue to count unless you pick your ass off the canvas.
Yep. Hate to say it, but it's true.
They're wrong. It's true. So why have a rule book? Why apply? Why say you can't hit below?
Because some of the appeal of boxing is its subjectivity. That's why we don't want to know what the scorecards are until the end of the fight. Yeah. That's why
they used to show them on TV. They used to say, like, every round, like, here are the scorecards.
It was a disaster, and even the open scoring from WBC or whatever was a disaster. We as fans may say one thing, but secretly we like it. We like not knowing what happens until that very end. We like the controversy. We watch it. We eat the stuff up. We talk about it. We do YouTube clips on it. I mean, this is what we live for.
Suspense.
There you have. We're still talking about Mayweather Ortiz.
Yeah, Mayweather Ortiz. You know what I mean? Tons of questionable calls, tons of weird things that happen, and we as fans seek these things out, and we as fans give them traffic and give them clout and give them merit.
There you have it. From the Outlaws Boxing Club in Tarzana, for ESNEWSReporting.com, I'm Elliot Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Secback.